My name is Araf Razapsek. I'm from the company RSIC, and we're from the Netherlands with an extra development center in Pune, in India. We're specialized in mobile software development. We started out in 2001, and we specialized in BlackBerry from 2004. We've been a long time BlackBerry Alliance member also since that period, one of the first in Europe. Also one of the few companies who've actually done development work for RIM. We're currently offering development services and a number of generic products, of which by far the most popular is our RSIC survey application, which allows for the development of development and easy deployment of mobile forms. These are either developed or are created straight on the BlackBerry device or using a web-based interface. When you create it on the web-based interface, the forms are pushed straight away to the BlackBerry and can be used by the end user, one or multiple. We offer a lot of extra options with that to configure and control the total application remotely, either using custom best policies or using a web-based interface to configure individual applications. Application is extremely useful in situations that require the capturing of a GPS location or the capturing of one or multiple photographs. You can add those photographs to your data set, and it can be used, for instance, for keeping track of vandalism, keeping track of basically anything that requires the recording of photo material. In Belgium, we've done a very successful project with the city of Roeselare. There has been a project where policemen and city officials are using the BlackBerry with our software to record small offenses. For instance, someone has wrongly parked their car. The official then goes to this and sees this offense, takes a picture. If the offender is there, asks for the electronic identity card, inserts the identity card in an official RIM smart card reader, so it's totally secure. Then all the data that's required for that specific form is extracted from the identity card, put on the form. Additional information can be recorded, like the license plate or any other circumstantial information. And then the data is sent in XML format or PDF format, depending on what our client wants, to a certain location. And that's also what we're very interested in. We're looking for partners to work with. We've got a number to either resell our solution or to integrate the data that is captured by our solution in backend systems. So you're talking about databases, ERP systems, CRM systems. It's basically a lot of different things that can be done with this type of solution. Well, the typical profile of our partner companies are either companies that do a lot of system integration work, mobile consulting. Basically it comes down to partners that know the mobile world and that know how to treat XML data or CSV data, stuff like that. But also, since we offer full multimedia capabilities, right? So you can add pictures, you can add sound bites, you can add even videos to your data set. It also comes down to processing that type of information and doing something useful with it. And, depending on where you are in the world, I'm sure that there would be some interesting opportunities. Our main website is www.rsic.mobi, M-O-B-I. That's our main website. It's in English and in Dutch. Well, English would be most useful, I think, for this venue. On the contact page are our contact details, and we're very interested in meeting any sort of company that would be interested in this type of solution. Just ask for Araf, and then you'll be put through to me. This is my third Alliance event, so and we've been Alliance member for 5 years, so I didn't attend the first two, and I'm sorry about that, because if I look at the whole vibe and the location, it's a really good opportunity to network and to meet all kinds of partners, and each year we come back and we do a lot of good business based on this event, so that's definitely a good thing.
And do you go to the American one,
the West? Yes, I've been to the West not this year but last year. It was useful, but less person to person than this situation. It's less individual. Yeah.
And what's your favorite BlackBerry?
Currently, I think due to the unavailability of the newest model with the touchpad, I have an 8900. What's it called? A Curve, right? It's a Curve. And yeah, that's my favorite because it's smaller than the Bolt. But the moment that the one with the touchpad comes out,
that's gonna be yours.
Yeah, that's gonna be mine. Yeah.
And what are you demonstrating on the Curve then?
I'm gonna show, and don't mind the fact that my BlackBerry is totally havened and in very bad shape. I'm gonna show an example of a municipal form that can be used to record a certain situation and to dispatch required personnel to take care of the resolution.
Fantastic, let's have a look.
All right. So what we see here is an overview of all the different forms that we have. So you see the small camera, you see the counting symbol, and you see also a number of other icons. These are different form types. So you have a counting form that allows you to systematically count all kinds of different things, useful for statistical observations or for municipal usage. We have the regular forms, and what I'm going to show you is a photo form, basically allowing to add one or multiple photographs to the form data. Now, here we see we have the date. So this is a form that's created on a web-based interface. You can also create it on the BlackBerry, but that's basically, it has a high novelty value, but it's not very useful, of course. And what you can see here is you have a date. You can enter an observation type, right? And so let's say I have a problem with the road. Now, this is a Dutch word, but basically it says observer. Now, I enter here a name. Now, a city, right? So here's a city that I select. Here is a area. So this is a filtered list depending on the city that I selected. Now, then I can record or I can enter the location, or I can record my GPS position. If I press the GPS button, then it will open the GPS dialog and it tries to determine my current location. The moment it gets it, it will populate the fields with my current coordinates. But since we're indoors, that's gonna waste a lot of time. Now, here you see a picture field. So this form just contains one, but multiple pictures can be added. So let's just take a picture of our banner.
Nice.
And let's go on. Now the picture is resized and then put on the form, but it's just for display purposes. The picture remains intact on the resolution and quality it was originally taken in. At the moment that I press the save or the save and new button, this data set is saved and then can either be exported in XML, PDF, comma separated format, as well as MS Excel format.
Could be read at the office, for example?
Read at the office if you choose for PDF, or processed further if you choose for further system integration. What's interesting to note is that the Belgian version also allows to sign this data and making it impossible to change anything in a data set. And even adding, if you choose for a legal signature, even adding legal obligations to the data set.